talking more about the book now. This is not to give away more about it, because we are about to unveil the launch date as well. So that is for taking in some time. But before we go to the book, there are a few insights we all wanted to know, for me personally as well, on behalf of everyone out there. So since the first book in the series was about Lord Ram, the second one was about Lady Sita, and now third one we all are referring to, the Ravan, it reads itself in the title. But now there's a question which comes to my mind. So because you've given the title Ravan, you have portrayed him right there on the cover as well. So should we all be taking him as a protagonist or an antagonist? And there's an add-on to it. After having swirled the pages of the entire book, and I'm really sure everybody's going to do it very, very soon, is there a point where we all start to empathize on Ravan at some point?
Okay. You know, I mean, he's in traditional Sanskrit storytelling style, in Sanskrit, the word for villain, what we are told, is Khalnayak. But actually, villain for Khalnayak is actually a wrong translation. That's not what Khalnayak actually means. Nayak is someone who takes the story forward. Khala means doubtful. So anyone who takes a story in a doubtful direction is the Khalnayak. It doesn't necessarily mean villain. It's just, because villain is a very loaded term, right? So in the Valmiki Ramayana and the original versions, he's not seen as a villain. He's the antagonist. Lord Ram is the protagonist. That's the way it is. I think that's how I have tried to portray him. There's a lovely line that the marketing guys came up with in the blurb at the back, that without the darkness, light has no purpose. And that, I think, describes Ravan to a major extent, because without a so-called villain, what would the gods do? Right? They need someone to fight. So, the greatest god needs the greatest Khalnayak. Yeah. That's what makes him very interesting and exciting as a character to write about as well. He's not just a thug. He's not just someone who kills. He's a brilliant scholar. He's a brilliant musician. He's invented instruments which exist. And at least myths say that he invented those instruments which exist till today. So Rudra Veena, which is probably the best stringed instrument that one can find, that was invented by him in honor of Lord Shiva. The Ravan Hatta, the Rajasthani, I'm sure all of you must have heard of it. That was also apparently invented by him. The word Ravan Hatta means the sound of Ravan's grief. So he was a very deep guy. Massive ego also. Severe anger management issues also, obviously, but an interesting character to write about, yeah, no doubt.
Now, maybe for me as a young reader, our perceptions are definitely taken for granted about Ravan, as you've already mentioned, but I'm really looking forward to read this, because you never know what am I going to make out of Ravan after finishing that last page off.
So you, I don't know about sympathize or empathize, but you'll understand him. That's what at least I'm trying to do.
And feels he being such a humble devotee of Lord Shiva, and that is after doing that ghor tapasya, he has received his natural superpowers from Lord Shiva. I really believe he to be a good person at the end of the day. Now this is my take, and this is going nowhere for sure. Nobody's going to take me seriously.
Put an evil eye on his words.
Yes, absolutely. So actually, Zoya, I should have asked the question before he shares his insight about Ravana. But nevertheless, now I can ask you, what is your perception about the very Ravana? If you don't consider whatever he has said right now.
We grew up knowing the story and hearing the story and having it reinterpreted. So it was very interesting for me to hear what he has to say and say that there's a lot of depth to the character. Because, you know, there is, like he said, when you have such a strong hero, when you create something that's the opposite of it, or that's something that's the other path or the other side or the other whatever, it has to be as strong, you know, in a different way. And as he said, that it takes the story ahead. But when you're a child, you're just like, he kidnapped her, you know, that's the thing that sticks in your head and you don't go beyond that. But somewhere now, when you look back and you think back at it, I think he also somewhere was weak and wanted to be liked by her. You know, he wanted to be liked. I mean, it was important to him to be liked. And I think that that's therein, even though you, however you demonize him, there is the human failing and a weakness which comes from the same desire to be loved and to be accepted and to be, you know, somewhere.
There's a lovely line in the Valmiki Ramayana, which I quote in here, that where Ravan says that desire in a man is debilitating because it makes him weak.
Exactly.
Because it makes him compassionate and hence makes him weak. He saw compassion as weakness. But right. So I actually quote that line right. Over there. Yeah.
But it did make him
weak. But he's a very interesting character to write about. So hope you guys like it. And those of you, sorry, I forgot one thing. Those of you on Facebook, Instagram, the guys who get really into stuff, you know I like to leave clues in the books, right? On the covers, in the books as well, for stuff that you can explore and discuss. So this cover has clues as well. I'm not going to make it easy for you. I'm not going to explain what they are. I'm just going to point some of them out, okay? There's stuff carved out here. So I've made it a little easier for you. Now you guys need to figure it out. What does this mean? There's some other stuff also, but I'll not make it so easy.
So on this note, we have already seen the cover. We are expecting a beautiful content like he has been doing it for years and years. Is there anything you would want to ask Amish on your personal forefront about the very book?
About this book?
Yes.
No, I want to read it. I mean, will you ever write something? Will you ever create a world? Because, I mean, our mythology is already intergalactic, so to speak. You know, so will you ever create something that's completely new? Just take the same spaces, take the same world, the same characters can come in and out. But like characters, the lead characters, being completely new. Would you create a whole new universe?
You know, I actually have a story idea in mind, which is set in the modern day, actually, not in the epic era. And it brings in gaming, it brings in time travel, and it brings in extraterrestrial life as well.
Okay,
but it's linked to this world.
So this is what I want.
It's linked to this world. So I don't know when I'll write that, but I do have that idea, and that'll be a long series as well.
I've booked
it. Let me see. Oh, you booked it? I was about to ask you.
That's what I'm asking.
I was about to ask you, are you going to do something outside of...
I have booked it. Yeah.
Done. Yeah, it's tentatively called Leela. Leela means the game played by the gods.
Lovely.
A few more outcomes, insights from Amish. Now that's some good news we weren't expecting, but yes, definitely. As your fans, thank you so much for giving that insight. And ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for Zoya as well.
Oh, one second. No, before that, I need to thank her personally because she took a lot of trouble to come here, okay? Because she came late, not because she left late, she left bang on time. And I'm sure many of you guys would have read it on Twitter, the road to Jootara, I think there was some bridge collapse or something.
It's not yet collapsed.
So she had to take a...
But they've shut the entire artery, so don't take that road.
And she had to take a long way to get here. So a loud round of applause for her. She took a lot.
Sorry for the delay and thank you for waiting.
I am so grateful that you made it.
I was getting stressed that everyone's waiting.
Okay. No, it's cool. It's cool.
You're saying something
else? No. The publisher is telling me something that I'm supposed to say, but I'm too dumb to understand. Huh? Oh, yes, sorry. Okay. My publisher manages me. She was trying to mouth the words, but I didn't get it. Okay.
No, actually, she's helped me.
The guys on Facebook, Instagram, and for the media, the book is releasing on 1st July. Pre-orders have opened. It's available on, and pre-orders are available on all stores. But since I'm sitting in Crossword out here, Crossword is also taking pre-orders. And the book will release on 1st July, I got it right. My publisher's nodded. Is there anything else I missed? No? Okay. I think she's mouthing idiot now. No? Okay. Okay, that's it.
So brilliant, ladies and gentlemen. 1st of July, it is where you all can expect Ravan, Enemy of Aryavarta, Book 3 of the series, Ramchandra. Many congratulations, Amish. Many congratulations
to you as well
for being a part of this beautiful launch. Congratulations to the entire Westland team and to all the friends and fans who are expecting this launch. Thank you so much.